Guten Morgen, ich bin bei Herrn Drögel angemeldet.
Bei wem?
Bei Herrn Drögel.
Drögel. Kenne ich nicht.
Er ist hier Direktor.
Ach, Sie meinen Herrn Direktor Drögel. Der ist in der Fabrikation, immer geradeaus durch die Schiebetür.
Hey everyone, hello and welcome to Hotanas Box & Stop and my little special Christmas sweet taste testing on December 6th. If you're wondering what's so special on December 6th, it's a Christmas holiday here in Germany. It's Nikolaustag, St. Nicholas Day. I've discovered this holiday more specific in an extra video that I will put up here in the eye. I hope that's the right direction. In the eye on the top right corner of the screen. And yeah, you can learn more about December 6th on that video. As I promised you back in October, actually I'm filming this in October, that's why there's still autumn and fall decoration here. We have Milka Christmas Sweets as a cooperation with Nintendo. And we have Kit Kat from other countries in the world that are not Germany. This is the first time I'm doing a taste testing. I love sweets, I love chocolate a lot, but I'm usually not eating that much, especially not that much in a rapid succession. I don't know if I'll manage to film all of this in one day, so if there's a weird cut, if the angle changes or anything, that's why I needed to take a break and continue filming on another day, because it's just much. Really, really much. I have my water here for any necessities, and I have a container here for the broken open sweets, because I will not eat a complete package. I will only eat a part of it, and that's enough for one day if I have so much to do. So without further ado, let's get to it. I want to start with the Nintendo Milka Corporation. We have these bonbon types in Mario, in Peach, and in Luigi. And we have this figure type only with Mario, because at the time I'm filming this, I do not own the Luigi variant, and I don't know if I'll be able to get this the Luigi variant at all. So I can't just wait until I get the Luigi variant. I haven't seen it in stores around here. I had to order it online, and they didn't offer a variation selection. So yeah, the Luigi variant should be exactly like the Mario variant, with slight color changes and motif changes, but in itself it should be the same. So I would say we'll begin with this. I'll break the seal off, which is very strong and very sticky. Alright, and then we should be able to simply open this up like a jar. Right, we have a look into it. I hope I'm able to zoom in very well in editing phase, because the camera is a bit far away from me to get all of this in the screen. It couldn't be helped. We have these kinds of snowballs. Got them twice. Then we've got these Oreo bonbons, which I'm really, really looking forward to. Three of them. And we have a sticker, as it seems. Yes, it's a sticker with Mario. So the other one would obviously have a sticker with Luigi. I don't think there's any more to it. Or are there several? Let's see what's written on the box. Yeah, it should be two stickers. In my great planning ahead, I obviously have not put a knife or a scissor in here, so I have to cut for a second and get something to open this. Okay, I'm back with a pair of scissors. Let's see that I'm able to open it up without damaging the stickers itself. Alright, here we are, there are stickers of Mario and Toad. Now I don't know what the second sticker would be on the Luigi pack, unfortunately. I assume it's something similar, some Nintendo motif we've already seen several times probably. But it's really really nice to have these stickers. They're not the main reason for buying this, but it's nice to have them. I'm sorry if I'm sometimes looking a bit off from the camera. I'm not used to look into the camera while filming, so this probably happens a lot today. I'm sorry. Okay, let's start with testing these snowballs. Scissor time. Now, I know these are German candies, but I don't usually buy Milka, so I have no idea how this tastes. I haven't eaten something from Milka in 10 years, around 10 years. Should be the case. Right, we have these white snowy balls. So they should be filled with chocolate inside. We have a surprisingly crisp white sugar outside, which nearly tastes like waffle, or feels like waffle in the mouth, with a very sweet chocolate inside. Sweeter than I'm used to. But that's okay. They're really not bad. They are actually pretty good. Next up, the Oreo bonbon. We have a milk chocolate around and probably some Oreo cream inside. It doesn't taste much like Oreo, so a little bit. It tastes like the white Oreo cream mixed with Milka chocolate, basically. And there's a little bit of crunch in here, so probably some cookie splinters. It's okay. I must say, so I'm absolutely not used to the sweetness of Milka anymore. Milka is a very, very sweet chocolate, and I usually tend more towards the more darker chocolate, less sweet, less sugary. I'm not used to it anymore. Wow. It tastes good, no question about it, but I'm not used to it anymore. Let's get to the bonbons, and I'll open up peach first. It should be the same kinds of sweet in here, so this is more of an unboxing. Let's see. Let's see what we have here. Lots of sweets. You put that down for a sec. We have more of these snowballs. have more of the Oreo bonbons. And we have a Milka bonbon of kind of some sort. So one more Milka treat I have to taste. Well, let's get to it. I assume it's just milk chocolate in a bonbon form. Looks from the outside like the Oreo bonbons. Let's see. There's a white and a dark side to it. I actually bit it, so I completely bit off the light side. Which is tasty, it's very milky. And the rest is very chocolatey. Again, that common Milka sweetness. It's not bad. I'm just not used to it anymore. Then we have this pink bracelet. Let's open it up. Surprisingly, it's not peach. It's Yoshi. It was Yoshi X and stars, superstars. But it's pink and it's obviously way too big for my wrist. And finally, we've got stickers again, surprisingly again with Mario. Let's see if at least something peach related is in here. We have Mario, we have Luigi, and we have Yoshi. I assume the stickers that might be in the Luigi figure will end up somewhere in these bonbons as well. The other bonbons should be more or less the same with different merchandise, so I'll open this up and show them to you. The Luigi bracelet is with Luigi, 1-up mushrooms and coins. I hope it's very visible. If I notice during editing that it's hard to recognize, I'll shoot extra footage of it for you to see. And we have the exact same set of stickers like in the other bonbon. So I bet the Luigi figure would have the exact same stickers as the Mario figure. It's a bit sad that they didn't pay attention to variation in here. Let's open the last one up. Maybe it's random and I've just got unlucky. I'm not gonna open it up. It already starts like the other two, so there's definitely no sticker variation. I mean, if you buy two differently for two children, two siblings, you at least avoid infighting, but you know, a little bit of variation would be nice. I mean, why put three different outside designs if the only difference are these cheap bracelets and you don't even have a peach bracelet? That's really a shame. The Mario bracelet is with Mario, the superstars and the super mushrooms. Alright, let me clean up this mess a bit. First, what I've noticed is that there's... Okay. I saw a performance line on these bonbons and I assumed that you could remove the character artwork from it. But it's actually made that you couldn't really drag on it and rip it apart in the middle. Yeah. Glad I didn't do that, because in case of Luigi, at least, it would have ripped the hand apart, and I will keep these, obviously. So yeah, let me clean up this mess a bit, and then we'll continue with Kit Kat.
Ach, Gnefrau, das ist wirklich nett.
Mein Name ist Lose. Sie hatten mir damals freundlicherweise Ihre Visitenkarte gegeben.
Ich weiß, ich weiß. Und nun bin ich ganz, ganz froh, dass Sie zu uns gefunden
haben. Herr Drögel, ehe Sie einen falschen Anruf.
Wir sind seit 27 Jahren führend in der Herstellung und im Vertrieb von Schokoriegeln.
Herr Drögel, bevor Sie...
Wenn ich das noch sagen darf, ich habe die Firma übernommen von meinem Onkel Erich Klotz. Meine Mutter ist eine Klotz. Und führe das Unternehmen weiter unter dem Namen Riegel Klotz, weil der Klotzriegel sich als Markenartikel gut eingeführt hat und weil die Bezeichnung Riegel Drögel oder Drögel Riegel also auch nicht so
ganz... Herr Drögel, ich hatte eigentlich nicht die Absicht, berufstätig zu werden. Aber aus sehr privaten Gründen möchte ich nicht den ganzen Tag zu Hause bleiben. Das ist auch der Grund, warum ich...
Frau Lose, ich weiß, was Sie sagen wollen. Wir bieten Ihnen eine freie Mitarbeit als Gegengewicht zu Ihrem häuslichen Partner, zu dem Sie ja wohl einen gewissen Abstand brauchen, um nicht um sich nicht
Ja, ja, aber woher wissen Sie, ob ich für diese Tätigkeit geeignet bin?
Das fühle ich.
Alright, I'm back from the Milka Sweets and on to Kit Kat, which I'm looking really forward to, because the sweet Milka taste is still everywhere in my mouth and I'm glad to rinse it with some darker chocolate. Without further ado, let's start with the dark chocolate. I think from Japan, based on the kanji, but or the characters. Not 100% sure, so, but I'm actually pretty sure. I don't like kanjis usually. We have these mini Kit Kat packages, which is pretty handy right now for me. Let's put this aside. Okay. As I announced, I'll only eat part of it, half a slice. Let's see how it tastes. That's good. It's more sweet than I'm used to, because I really eat... My main chocolate is 70% chocolate. There's a lot of wafer in here. It's less chocolatey and more wafery, but it's super, super delicious. This is really good, guys. If you have a chance to grab some up, do so. These are really, really good. Now let's get to the more experimenty tastes. Let's get to matcha tea. I've never drunk matcha tea. I'm super curious about the taste, though. You would think that this is Japanese, but it's actually not Japanese. It's based on the characters, I would guess it's Taiwanese. I don't exactly know. I will put it in the screen. I have a list where I've got these from. I just didn't remember to put this aside here. So without further ado. We have a very green flavor, green color, I mean. So yeah, my first matcha tea, or green tea. Let's see how it tastes. Mmm. definitely not my favorite. You taste green tea all right. Not gonna finish that. Oh. It's a bit stronger than I would liked. It's green tea. It's green tea with chocolate. It's not bad. It's really not bad. It's just not my taste. Really not my kind of taste. Ah. The green tea flavor is a bit too strong for me. How fitting that we have another green tea flavor here. This time with red beans, which you would also think is Japanese, but it's like the other one I think from Taiwan. No, I still taste the green tea. And my stomach already tells me to stop. I'm gonna continue. That's the best time to compare it to the completely green tea one. I think it's the Anko beans from Japan. I always wanted to taste them too. Let's see if the beans ease it up a bit. You don't see the red that the package promises. Let's see. It's better. Still not my favorite. Let's see if I find someone who might like these. Definitely not my taste. Oh dear. I want the sweet taste from the cupcake.
Für mich wäre Ihre ganz persönliche Meinung über das Herbstangebot unserer neuen Schokoriegel von größter Wichtigkeit.
Meine Meinung?
Die Meinung einer Frau von Bildung und Geschmack. Wenn Sie zum Beispiel dieses Angebot einmal verkosten wollen, das ist eine hochwertige Kokosfüllung mit Pistazienschaum als Trägermasse. Für ältere Menschen haben wir die Waldmeister Weichcreme-Variante entwickelt. Die Geschmackspartikel entfalten sich übrigens am besten durch abwechselndes Lutschen und Kauen. Ich weiß nicht, ob Sie da schon...
Doch, ja.
Alright. Rocky start with a Kit Kat. I'm very, very positive about the other taste, so there's nothing too experimental in here, thankfully. I know that I will never make a food channel. But this is your Nikolaus present. I will go on. My body will so pay me back for that. But I will go on. Let's get it out with a sweet or strawberry. Hopefully that will put it away. It's limited edition flavor. No idea which country. I really can't tell from the package. I'll put it into the screen for you, obviously. Let's go. The company I bought this from made these German translation stickers on the back, which unfortunately is directly over the tearing. It already smells very, very strawberry. It's pink in there. I have very, very high hopes. This is good. Definitely is the best to combat the green tea taste. So much better. It's very bubblegummy. It has this typical artificial strawberry taste. This bubblegum taste. But it's so good after that green tea. Have I mentioned that I'm not that big of a tea drinker? And when I drink tea, it's usually with berries or with lemongrass, you know, something on the lighter, fruitier side. The strawberry is very good after the green tea. No, it's really okay. There's better strawberry chocolate here in Germany, I think. I personally think, but it's really good. It's not bad. Not bad at all. Let's stay with the fruity side. Here we have orange from Great Britain. And it's very interestingly wrapped up. Oh, and it smells like orange. It has a really, really strong orange smell to it. Oh, it smells good. This really smells good. Let's open this up. Smells like some orange chocolate I last ate as a kid. So, high hopes. Also tastes like it. Again, tastes a bit artificial, but it's really good. Not much visible going on in the Kit Kat itself. It's just good. It's really good. I'll try to wrap this up a bit again so I know what taste it is. I definitely should have get a bigger container. I will fill it differently later on. Orange is really good. It's pretty much like what I expected it to taste like. So it's not really a surprise, but it's a pleasant taste. Let's get back to something more dark, with mocha. It's written matcha, but it's certainly coffee, so I guess it's mocha. don't know how you Brits spell mocha. Same kind of aluminium foil packaging. Of a piece. That's enough. Again, nothing really going on inside. Strong coffee smell. Really strong smell. And a very strong coffee taste. It's not bad. It's a bit too much coffee for me. Like the green tea, just not that strong. My mom will love these. That's a good point. I know who to give this to. My mom will love this. That's exactly her taste.
In unserem Herbstangebot führen wir zwei Krokant-Kompositionen, eine
davon. Sind es noch, ich meine, wie viele? Im Moment fühle ich mich nicht sehr.
Oh, darf ich? Sie haben sehr schöne Hände.
Ach?
Wie sind nun bisher Ihre Eindrücke über die Kollektion insgesamt?
Ja, also bei dem da, da ist mir weniger. Da habe ich mich hinterher besser gefühlt.
Das war Kirsch-Nougat?
Ja. Aber das hier, das braune.
Maronencreme?
Ja, da ist mir ziemlich, also...
Ich verstehe. Und die Doppelnuss im Sahnemantel?
Auch, das auch.
Mögen Sie Ernst zu mir sagen?
Two to go. I'm able to do this. I won't give up now. If everything goes well, you will see some clips from a German comedian in here, Loriot, without himself, in one of his movies. There's a longer scene that is very, very fitting to my experience right now. So I might cut this in between and hope the video isn't taken down by copyright. I'm sorry. Let's continue. We have cookies and cream next. Same kind of packaging again. Now at least we have something visually going on. We have the light and the dark side. Let's see. It tastes a bit like a lighter, more chocolatey Oreo cookie. Slightly. It's really good. It's really good. I like this. But it's sweet. We are back at sweet again. But it's good. At least it's good. One more of you guys and I'm done. Alright. Was war für 16 von last? Dark Mint. I love dark chocolate. I love mint. I hope this is the best of all of the tastes. I hope it doesn't disappoint me. I could really use some dark mint chocolate. No, actually, I could use everything else but chocolate right now. Oh God, this is way too much. But it's the last one, and it smells really, really minty. Oh, it smells like after eight, which I hope it nearly tastes like, because after eight is really, really delicious. If you don't know what after eight is, let me know and I'll show it to you on a different day, on a different video. I don't even have some here, thankfully. So hopefully I'm not getting the wrong ideas. All right. By the way, I haven't thrown up in 20 years. No joke, I really didn't. Let's hope it doesn't come to it today. But I don't think so, so you don't have to worry about me. I really feel that it's too much chocolate for me, but I'm not that sick by the chocolate. Not so far. Oh, it smells so good. It smells like it will help. Not much visually going on in here. Let's see how it tastes. It tastes like after eight. But more on the chocolatey side. After eight has a stronger mint flavor. This has a stronger chocolate flavor, and you have the wafer that after eight doesn't have. It's really, really good. It's as good as I hoped it to be. This is really, really good. Oh. And it helps. The mint helps to calm down the chocolate in my stomach. I'm done with the chocolate, guys. I made it alive. Oh my. It really helped getting this thick oversweetening feeling from in my body down. It was the right choice to put that last, really divorce. And since I'm seeing the back of the package right now, I really find it funny how different countries take their packaging differently. Like here in Great Britain you have this know your saving, how much calories it has. It really, really puts attention to it. Which I think is good. I think it's good that they put in the calories per single bar. We don't have that as much in Germany. We have it closer to here, but there's a lot of back text and then a rather small but visible small box for the nutritions, which is fine in my book. I guess everyone has to decide for themselves or herself how much they eat. And I really don't eat that much sweets. I know I look like it, but I don't. I have a disease called lipedema that makes me look so sick. I don't usually eat that much sweets. Oof. But I made it. Nearly. Why am I doing this? The shop I ordered this added a little gift, a little bonus gift. And it's a candy cane. We don't usually have candy cane here in Germany, or probably we have by now, but I've never seen it because I've never looked for it. It's not a German thing. It's something if we have some here, we adopted from America. It certainly has German writing on this, so this is German. I can't remember that I ever had candy cane before. And this is a Christmas video! Despite all this fall and autumn decorations, it's still a Christmas video! I will so regret this. I won't eat much. I will only get a little bit of taste for my American watchers out there. German trying candy cane. Okay, that's the way to open it, seems. Fuck it. There we go. It broke in transit anyway. So, here we have a little bit. Let's taste it. It has a core inside, I guess that's normal. I know it's pretty much only sugar, so... Oh yes, it's sugary. Bad planning. Don't have anything here to spit it out. Come on. I must admit, it's not that bad. The piece that I had in my mouth right now really, really tasted very, very good. I expected to have a full sugar flavor in my mouth, that is, I won't taste anything else but sugar. But it's not the case. I don't know if it's strawberry or if it's cherry, but I had a... Yeah, it's not even written in here what flavor it has. Just that it's very, very much sugary. But it has a fruity flavor. And I really liked it. I think I will crush that into many, many little pieces and have one once in a while. But even the little piece that I broke off, it's too much for me right now after all this chocolate. I couldn't stomach it. This is more chocolate than I've eaten in a long, very long time in one sitting. Oh, much. But I made it. Completely made it. And must admit, thanks to the dark mint Kit Kat and the candy cane for some strange reason, I'm not feeling so sick anymore than I did a few minutes back. green tea with beans, definitely not my taste. Very, way too strong. Way too bitter. No thanks, I won't eat them. I will not eat them completely. I will not try them again. The mocha flavor, bit strong for my taste. I'm sure my mom will love it. The rest of the flavors are very good. I especially like the orange and the dark mint Kit Kat. And Milka is sweet as I know it. Milka is always sweet. Milka has been always sweet. But I know it's very, very loved everywhere else in the world. And always considered as this, wow, this is great German chocolate. Let me tell you guys, Milka is on the bottom list of quality of chocolate in Germany. I'm not wanting to be mean to every Milka fan. Milka has a huge palette of flavors and it has a lot of fans, and that's okay. It might be on the cheaper end of the stick, but it's still good chocolate. I guess the only ones which were still cheaper in quality are the very cheap discounter ones that I have no intention to ever try. But the really, really good German chocolate is not Milka. That's mostly actually organic companies, more pricey ones. They are really good. And I should add, when it comes to KitKat also has a monopole, or a huge monopole, let's say it that way, on Ruby chocolate. Ruby chocolate, or red chocolate, is a fourth kind of chocolate next to dark chocolate, milk chocolate, white chocolate. It's a fourth kind of Ruby, of red chocolate. It's special because it's not artificial. It's not artificially flavored or colored. They just process the cacao bean from a special special type of cacao fruit in a way that it becomes a red, a pink reddish color, and a very, very fruity and taste. Like, it really tastes like you eat berry chocolate, but it's not. It tastes like white chocolate with berries, but there are no berries in there, and it's not white chocolate. It's pink, and it's naturally pink, and it's delicious. Is the only ones who can use this kind of chocolate right now, at least here in Europe, is KitKat. You also get this Ruby chocolate in Japan from KitKat, and it's really, really good. If you have the chance to try it, try it. That's just a little extra I want to add, because that's pretty much the whole expense of exotic KitKats, I know. The other types of KitKat I've seen here in Germany and tried and really liked are the normal one, white chocolate, New York cheesecake, and peanut butter. All very good. New York cheesecake is among my favorites after the Ruby chocolate. Dark mint and orange are top on high there right now as well. Green tea, not so much. Okay, I've talked enough about this. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it wasn't as bad as it felt like filming at some points. I hope I managed to put the comedian clips in here without them taking my video down. Obviously translated. But if I manage to get something, you'd see that. I hope this video was good in the end. I'll see you while editing, I guess. I hope you still have a great, great Christmas time. I hope you enjoy the rest of the advent calendars, which I think might be the Milka advent calendars without chocolate testing. I haven't filmed any of the advent calendars yet. I'm still hoping to get some feedback on which calendars you'd like to see more, prefer to see. Currently, if no one objects, I'm going with the Milka ones, so not eating the chocolate, showing the chocolate and showing the extra stuff inside, so it fits with the Milka themes that we had at the beginning of this video. Yeah, Not much to say. I'm already taking too long and talking too much. Have a great rest of the Christmas season, of the holiday season, no matter what you're celebrating. I hope you don't mind if I constantly mentioning Christmas. I'm not Christian myself, but Christmas is tradition for me, not religious, just tradition. So I fall into the complete mention of Christmas all the time. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope I see you again. Probably next year. Also, you'll see me in the advent calendar. I'm talking too much. Maybe I'm on a sugar rush.